What's up, guys? It's Robert Fuhrer, your creative mentor. And this year I've had lots of commissions, and I want to talk to you guys about how I accept commissions and about how commissions can be disastrous, some mistakes I've made, and how to protect yourself as an artist, designer, whatever you're doing, any type of freelance work. So the first thing that you have to consider is, how am I going to price my work? You have to have a method for it. There's lots of different methods out there. Some people go by time, how long it takes. Some people go by size. I personally go by size, considering what type of medium it is. So it'll be 1 inch by 1 inch equals X amount of dollars, and then I just times it by how wide and how tall it is. Now, as the paintings get bigger and bigger, sometimes the price has to be different, because lots of times a small oil painting takes as long as a large oil painting, but also a large oil painting takes more supplies. So you kind of got to figure out for yourself how you want to price it, but pick a price and stick with it, so that when you have a big show and there's multiple clients buying things, trust me, it just gets too confusing if your numbers are all over the place. What you could do is just write the price on the back of the painting, so it's easy to find and you'll remember in the future. Now, after you have a method for pricing your work, the next thing I learned the hard way. The next thing is, ask for a payment up front. Now, some people ask for 30%. I actually usually ask for 50%, unless it's a really old client and I've worked with them many times, then I might not even ask for any type of payment first, or if it's a good friend or family member. But be careful of strangers or people that you're not too used to, because they could take advantage of you. I remember one time here in Taiwan, I was hired to do a website, and it was word of mouth. We didn't actually have a contract, and the client didn't know my work very well. She asked me, okay, you know, do you know anyone that does this? And I told her, oh, I used to be a professional web designer, and I could totally help you do it. We could do this flash website for your hotel. Anyways, I spent 2 months making it, and during that time, you know, I kept contacting her, showing the progress, and finally when it's done, we got together, had a meeting, and I was supposed to be paid the payment, and when we talked, we were using English, and she was actually in the States. So when I told her the price, I told her the price will be $2,000, meaning 2,000 USD dollars for a homepage and 5 pages. And she was paying, she took out 2,000 NT dollars to pay me, and I was like, no, it's actually 2,000 USD dollars, which is more like 60,000. Now, I ended up getting most of the money, but I learned a humongous lesson. Be very careful when you're doing commissions overseas. Make sure you guys got your currency straight. And, you know, so make sure you get paid half in advance. If I would have said, okay, I need half in advance, give me 30,000, she'd be like, what, 30,000? Because she obviously didn't know how much a website was worth. So I learned that the hard way. After that, I always ask for half up front to make sure we're on the same page. And that way, if you don't get paid the last half, at least you cover some of your time and expenses, and it's not a complete loss. So once you're out there and you're gaining commissions either through Instagram or from friends and families, when someone says, oh, I have a friend that wants a portrait, the next critical thing is to act fast because timing is so important. Lots of times with art, people, it's kind of an impulse buy. So if you don't really, jump on it, they might buy somebody else's work or a Ferrari or something else. Because if you think about it, usually art is a luxury item that people don't really need. So usually it's they see it and they want to buy it right now. So it's a good idea to hurry and get that, you know, half of the payment so they're already committed and they'll follow through with it. So yeah, don't be shy. You can, you know, make sure your terms are clear, like you'll pay me half now and half when I hand you the painting, or if it's a really expensive painting and they want to do payments or like a couple installments or whatever it is. Like I did a 16,000 USD dollar sculpture and they paid me for 2 years and it worked out just fine. So as long as they keep paying, you're good to go. And that's something that you have to agree before you start doing it. And same with that, that sculpture, I got half of it up front. So I wasn't worried to spend a bazillion dollars on all the supplies. Another time that I commissioned, I got about 2 years ago, it was a cram school. They wanted a big sculpture of an elephant in their entryway. Well, I bought the supplies because I trusted the person that was hiring me. And then they backed out at the last second and I was stuck with all these supplies. So sometimes trusting them, even if you know, I knew her for like 5 years and then it was her boss ended up backing out. But I ended up having to, you know, eat it on the cost of all the supplies. So yeah, the next thing after you've they've committed, they say they want to do it, they're willing to pay you half down, you got half of it down, you got to remember, it's super important to know exactly what the client's asking for. If it's a portrait, what's the exact size? Do they want it framed? Is it not framed? How are we doing the shipping? Is the shipping including in the cost or is it separate? I've run into problems with portraits where I took creative license and created these elaborate backgrounds from things I knew about the people, and it ended up they didn't like it. They didn't like all the things I added. So I ended up having to paint a second portrait. I wanted to keep the first portrait because it felt so awesome and I liked it. I painted what I wanted, right? And I'm like, okay, well, here's the portrait you're asking for. And they're like, well, wait a second. We like the other portrait too. So I ended up selling them two portraits. So make sure you make your life easy and know exactly what they want. And that goes in hand with the next thing is keep providing sharing the process with the client. If it's a really long painting that takes a long time, keep sending them periodically, send them pictures about the progress. As long as you're confident that it's looking good enough that they're not going to be like, what the heck is this? You know, you think it's coming along quite well, they could tell, oh, okay, it's coming together. It's good to send them, you know, a report of how it's going, about when you're gonna be done. Just a little enthusiasm. Then they'll get more and more excited about it and they can't wait till the project's done. Now, last but not least is these clients that you've worked with one time. They are your bread and butter. I mean, most of my clients that have purchased one painting, they purchase a second painting, a third painting. They become your collectors. So make sure you give them even though you're asking for half of up front, give them really awesome service. Finish it early. Don't drag your feet, you know, and treat them with love because they're the people that are feeding you. So there you have it. There's a couple experiences I've had. Learn from my mistakes. Make sure you get half of it up front, or just don't even start. Don't even go buy the canvas or anything if you don't get half of it up front. And commissions are, they're usually really awesome and they go well, or they go quite awful. Either it's hard getting the payment, or they don't like what you've done and you have to do another one. But usually in the past, if I do it and they don't like it, I usually like it, because I usually only give people what I like. So it means that they didn't like it because I took too much creative license. But that's okay, because I had fun doing it. But now I can give them the whatever they want in a different one. But I've noticed whenever somebody's asked me to redo it, they still like the other one, and they usually end up buying it too. So don't hesitate to do another one unless you're swamped with other commissions, and you could probably sell two out of it, or, you know, give them a discount or whatever. But don't give them the one that they didn't like for free. Whatever you do, tell them that you like this one so much and that you want to keep it for your portfolio, and that will trick them. It's like reverse psychology, trick them into wanting to buy both of them. Anyways, good luck with your commissions, and no art, no life. And thanks for subscribing and hitting your bell. I continue to add this type of content. Let me know if you like this type of content where you can watch me painting and I just do voiceovers, or let me know if you'd like to have it more personal where I have the camera on my head. Yeah, that would be good to have a little feedback. Anyways, I'm so grateful for you guys and your support, and thanks for everything. Talk to you later. Bye.